What does it look like to set up your first SDDC, Software-Defined Data Center, with VMware Cloud on AWS? In the previous onboarding video, we created the subscription, so now let's move ahead and create the SDDC. The first option lets you pick and choose the AWS region where you want this SDDC to be deployed in. Next up is the deployment type, either a temporary single host environment or a multi-host, and maybe even a stretch cluster if business requirements demand so. Next up is the host type, either I3 or I3EN, both with their own specifications when it comes to compute, memory, and storage. We select the name and the number of hosts that we want to deploy here. The host capacity and total raw capacity are shown here. There are some advanced configurations for larger deployments. Typically, you won't need those. We'll now connect to a customer-managed AWS account using this CloudFormation template. This is done to connect AWS networking and services to VMware Cloud on AWS. Wait until the CloudFormation stack is created and automatically is connected to your VMware SDDC. Now we can select the VPC, Virtual Private Cloud, and subnets from your AWS account. The subnets represent availability zones within the chosen AWS region. And because we selected the stretch cluster, we must provide two subnets because our SDDC will be stretched over two availability zones to increase availability. Next, we need to select a management subnet for the VMware SDDC components, like vCenter Server, ESX IOS, and NSX. Make sure you configure a subnet that doesn't overlap with other networks or other SDDCs connecting to this specific SDDC. Once we reviewed and confirmed all options, the Software-Defined Data Center, or SDDC, is deployed. What happens in the background is that AWS Fleet Management will pick EC2 bare metal hosts and start deploying the full VMware SDDC stack. It picks hosts in different racks in AWS data centers to optimize host availability. ESX IOS are installed, vCenter Server and NSX appliances are deployed and configured, everything that is required for the full VMware SDDC experience. When this process is done, you'll have an SDDC ready to go. The process can take some time depending on region and SDDC configuration. Typically, the end-to-end process takes 1 hour to 2 hours. Now that the SDDC is deployed, we can explore its details. Network and security options, add-ons, maintenance and troubleshooting options, the SDDC settings, and support information. The links to NSX Manager and vCenter Server, the vSphere client, are located on the top right side. This is also where you'll find options to add, remove, rename, and delete a SDDC. The first step is to access the vSphere client. This means we need connectivity to the vCenter Server instance. And there's multiple options here. Typically, a firewall rule or VPN is required to provide access to vCenter. Clicking on firewall rule takes you to the Management Gateway Firewall, a NSX construct. Here, you can add a firewall rule to provide management access to the vSphere client. Provide a name and configure the sources. Let's add a user-defined group. Enter the name of the group and add a member to that group by providing the IP address or IP range from where you'll need management access. Once done, review, save, and apply. Now configure the destination. The destination here being the predefined vCenter Server object. Select the required services, and when done, click on Publish to activate the changed firewall configuration. The firewall configuration is now all set for initial management access. The other option, as mentioned, is to set up a route or policy-based VPN. We'll go with the firewall rule in this demo. The predefined vCenter user is shown with options to copy the information to the clipboard. We can now open the link to the vSphere client and use the credentials as provided. The vSphere client is very much like on-prem vSphere environments. The number of hosts in the cluster matches what you have configured in the cloud console. They'll be tagged with the chosen availability zone. In the next demo, we'll look more into VMware Cloud on AWS vSphere client configuration and options. Make sure to check out other content on the VMware Cloud Tech Zone site.